To build the Advanced Solar Whirlygig, start by laying out the CD box and positioning the parts to check their locations. The motor comes in different sizes, so you may need to adjust the size of the rectangular cutout. Fold the sides of the box and insert the tab to close it. Then use a sharp pencil or X-Acto knife to punch holes through each of the 5 crossed black dots. Be sure to make the hole for the switch precisely in the middle of the box's edge. This might not align exactly with the black dot. Unfold the box and cut the opening for the motor with an X-Acto knife. Be sure to make your cuts on the inside of the rectangular outline. It's better for the motor to be a little snug than a little loose. Next, push the motor into the hole from the back with the small tabs on the inside of the box. On the back of the small solar cell, press strips of double-sided foam tape along both sides of the center wiring. Then peel the backing off the foam tape. Insert the cell's wires through the hole in the lower right side of the box and press the cell in place within its outline. Turn the box over and pull the solar cell wires apart about an inch. Then thread the tips of the cell wires through the motor eyelet tabs. Carefully bend the wires back, then crimp them with needle nose pliers and replace the motor in the box. Remove the nut and washers from the switch and push the switch through the hole on the side of the box. Replace the washers and the nut, and then tighten securely with needle nose pliers. Next, we'll solder 2-inch pieces of red and black wire to the back of the square glass solar cell. Note the polarity. One tab is marked with a black minus sign. Strip 1/2 inch of insulation from the black wire and solder the black wire to this metal ribbon tab. Solder the red wire to the other ribbon tab. Put pieces of clear tape over the solder connections so the tabs don't tear off. Cut short strips of double-sided foam tape and place them along the edges of the cell outside of the center wiring. Peel the backing off the foam tape and make sure the red wire is near the edge of the box and the black wire is closer to the center. Then insert the wires through the holes in the box and press the cell in place within its outline. Next, insert the ends of the music chip wires through the hole above the glass solar cell. Peel the backing off the chip and press it in place within its outline. Next, bend the red wire from the glass solar cell into a hook and thread the hook into the middle eyelet on the switch. Pinch the wire tight with pliers. Then connect the red wire from the music chip to either of the outside eyelets on the switch and crimp it tight. Next, twist together the ends of the black wires from the solar cell and the music chip. Then take the Whirlygig into the sunlight and test both the music and the motor circuits. If they work, then solder the connections to the switch, the twisted ends of the black wires, and both connections to the motor. Make sure the box can be closed with the motor in place. Open the box and add hot glue around the motor to hold it tight. Next, align the yellow wheel with the center of the CD. It helps to hold them up to the light and center the cross-shaped shadow on the back of the wheel with the hole in the CD. Use hot glue to attach the wheel to the CD. When set, put the yellow wheel on the motor axle. Then decorate the Whirlygig by hot gluing various art supplies to the CD. Finally, bring your Whirlygig into the sunlight and amaze your friends.